Hello, everybody, and welcome to Late Night Football. Welcome to our first match reaction show of the new season. It's pre-season, but it's still a match reaction show. And it's finished Melbourne Victory 1, Manchester United 4. I mean, that's a good run out. I guess in this pre-season, you can't really read much into the result. You can read a lot in the performance, though. You can't really read much into the result as such. I mean, they played a little bit, maybe it's hard to say, did they play better than against Liverpool? I'm not sure they did that, because I thought they were pretty bad against Liverpool. They were lucky to come away with the four goals that they did. This game, I mean, considering the level of opposition, I think you want to just see more from that first 11. I'm going to talk about the second half separately, but I think from the first half, at least, you expected more from the team. It wasn't that much. I mean, that goal, though, and again, this is not less rag on Maguire party, but that first goal is indicative of the issues that you have when you play Maguire and Lindelof together, because it just lack pace. They just lack pace. They don't have the intelligence, the awareness to play, you know, in a Ten Hag system. And, you know, just a ball straight down the channel. Luke Shaw is out of position. Elanga is out of position. It comes down. Lindelof has to cover the left side, which is what, you know, is hopefully that's what Lisandro Martinez will be doing. It comes over to cover. He can't. He gets beaten, and Maguire does have the recovery pace to come back and cut off the cross, and that's the goal. So that and these kind of things will happen in the season, because you know, a lot of teams will play on the counter. I think what we saw in this game is that United are going to be a ripe fodder for teams that play on the counter, because they just give them the ball and you know, then they'll break like that. So you've got to have defenders. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. The thing with Harry Maguire is he's always going to have moments like this in the game. He's going to have one or two, you know, moments where he's going to make mistakes. The question is, can the opposition team capitalize on it? And can, you know, United overcome those mistakes? And that's going to be the thing. Melbourne Victory, they got one mistake and they capitalized on it. And after that, they just strangely went very defensive. They started playing a very deep line. Started, you know, almost, you know, like pre-season park the bus. It was kind of like that. And I mean, it was a good exercise for United to understand, because a lot of teams will play that way. Probably with more attacking threat than Melbourne showed, but they will play that way. And so it's up to United to break them down. And that, I think, is where there were a lot of issues, because I don't think McTominay and Fred are good enough in that central midfield pairing. There was very little passing ingenuity, and Fred was taking all kinds of ridiculous shots, you know, at goal. I think he had three off long range shots that perhaps went nowhere near the goal. So that was pretty bad from him. I thought McTominay a lot of times lost the ball. The thing with McTominay is he tries, but he just is not good enough. He just doesn't have the ability. And he tried, you know, the recovery. He had a couple of shots as well, which kind of got deflected or blocked. So that was an issue. So there was just lack of dynamism in that midfield. I thought Shaw was pretty bad as well. Again, Shaw, I think Elanga didn't give him a lot to work with, but still, I thought Shaw lacked a lot of dynamism. And I just feel Malacia has a bit more dynamism about it. That doesn't necessarily mean that Malacia has to start over Shaw, that Malacia is better than Shaw. Just feel that Shaw lacks a little bit of that X factor, whatever that is. There's something lacking in Shaw right now. He's not the same player that he was maybe even a year ago at the Euros. He's not the same player. For some reason, something's changed. I don't know what it is. But that was where it was. And the game just kind of drifted away. Like, they were trying to end those passes. There were a couple of neat touches from Sancho. I thought Sancho was good. Dalot was good. For a change, Dalot actually tried to be more offensive and tried to actually put in some decent balls in, which was needed. So he was good. I thought Bruno was middling. You know, it was pretty average. I think he had a good chance that he should have scored from, but he didn't. But then he played a good role in that goal, because he, you know, in the second goal, I believe, because he plays a channel pass down. Dalot gets the ball, whips it back in towards Elanga. Elanga with a nice little pass, layoff, and Martial scores a very good goal. You know, I think Martial is someone who we're gonna have to rely on him, because there's really no forward options right now. So we're gonna have to rely on him. I thought that McTominay goal was, of course, very fortuitous. And I mean, you know, fair play to McTominay. He didn't celebrate it, because he knew how lucky that goal was and how flukish it was. Because it was, I think, you know, just takes the deflection and goes in. So that was good for you know, that was, you know, a lucky goal. The second goal was pretty well worked, I thought. And at least they came away with a 2-1 lead in the first half. So there are issues there. I don't think Maguire and Lindelof should be the starting pairing. And I don't think they will play a lot of games, especially now that Lisandro Martinez is almost done. You know, we've got a year we go from Fabrizio Romano. So that deal is almost done. I don't foresee them starting, because I think even if Maguire and Varane are the first choice centre-back pairing, if Varane is injured, I think Lisandro Martinez will play over Lindelof. I think that was the reason why Maguire played right back, because he's not there. I don't think Ten Hag wants him to play left back a lot. So, left centre back, rather, right centre back, or left centre back. So that was where it was. And I think it also showed the need for a midfielder, or even two. To be honest, I think maybe they need two midfielders, but they're going to get at least one. Hopefully we'll get someone. But that was where that was. So that was the first half. Second half was much more interesting and there was a lot more fluid. I found the first half boring as well. I have to say I found the first half very boring because like it was like a lot of sideways passes, a lot of endless recycling of possession because there was no dynamism. There was nothing that midfielders were trying. They just don't have the quality to put, you know, vertical passes. So there was a lot of sideways passes. I mean, at one point, to be honest, it was a sideways pass and the journalist, and he has the MUTV stream, the best that he goes, oh, what a wonderful pass from Maguire. What a wonderful sideways pass from Maguire. Like, that's like a normal pass for anyone else, but you know, that's what it is. Anyway, so going to the second half, and I thought there was some good performance in the second half. I mean, it can't be too harsh because at the end of the day, they are kids and a lot of them are kids. And a lot of them are, this is preseason. I thought Bai again showed why he isn't a starter. I know a lot of people like Bai. The problem is he always has mistakes in him. And he's erratic. He's very erratic. Like you don't know what you're going to get from him. He had a couple of really bad touches, but then he also got the assist. And that's Bai in a nutshell. And of course he gets injured. But that's the problem with Bai is that he's so erratic. You can't rely on a player like that. You can't necessarily build your team on a player like that. That's the problem with Bai. So therefore, any manager who says they want to start him, I support that. I see that. I see why they don't want to start him because you know what you get with Maguire. You know what you get with Lindelof. You know what you get with Varane. You just don't know what you get with Bai, and that is a big problem. So that was the issue with that. But again, it was a good pass for the goal, for the Rashford goal. So that was worked. I thought Charlie Savage, I know a lot of people talk about Zidane Iqbal and all of his pirouettes, but I thought Charlie Savage had a quietly good game. He played some wonderful passes, looked very neat in possession. I think both of them looked pretty neat in possession. I can't remember if they ever gave the ball away, to be honest. I can't remember if they gave the ball away. So, they gave possession away, can see the possession in dangerous areas. So they're very tidy, which is good. I hope they get good loan deals. I just hope they get good loan deals because I don't think they'll be getting a lot of chances. This season is good for their development. If you can get a good place to go on loan, maybe go to the championship, play a lot of games, try and build their craft, and then maybe come back in a season or two and try to fight for a first team place. Right now, I don't see that for them. Not because they're not good enough, because I don't think the manager is going to trust them. So therefore, that was something. But I like the way they played. And I thought Donny looked better than he did against Liverpool. I don't think number 10 is his role. I honestly don't think number 10 is his role. I think he's playing there right now. I don't know why he's playing there. Maybe he's playing there because there's no other number 10 and he doesn't want to play Savage or Iqbal up front, like closer to the striker. So he's playing them in the midfield too. That's the only thing I can think about. But number 10 is not Donny's role. So if he's going to play there, he's going to struggle again. That's what I figured out. I thought, and again, Rashford scored a good goal. But again, you know, a lot of people said he was playing as a striker. He wasn't playing as a striker. He was playing as a left winger. Ahmad was playing as a striker. So that's something in with Rashford. It was a well-taken goal, but I do think that a better goalkeeper would have saved it. It was not a very good shot. It was clever what he tried to do, but a good goalkeeper would have probably saved it because I don't think he got the execution in the way that he wanted to get. The idea was right. The execution, I don't think, was as good as it could have been. And so, therefore, a better goalkeeper would have saved that goal. But nonetheless, it's good for his confidence. It was pretty bad against Liverpool. So, it was good for him to get this goal and get a little bit of confidence back in his own play and in his own game. So, that was good. The fourth goal was also good play from Chong. For once, you know, you actually have someone running on the byline trying to put a cross in instead of always trying to cut in. So, that was good. And I mean, unfortunately, own goal. But the play was good around it. So that's what, again, like I said, you can't read too much into the result. You can't read too much into the goals, but you can read into the performance and you can kind of see where issues might arise. And I think against teams, this was a different test to the way that Liverpool play. Liverpool, you know, are the kind of team that I think United will struggle against anyway because of the fact that they play so fast and that they can get caught out very easily. And then from teams that know how to play and play past the press. This game was different because this is basically teams who are playing going to park the bus. And I think if Melbourne had been a little bit more adventurous at 1-0, I think they probably could have got a goal or two more in that early period. And I think teams like Crystal Palace, Aston Villa, those kind of teams, because those kind of teams that like to park the bus, don't mind playing deep, they will trouble Bournemouth as well. Or, you could even talk about other teams that are going to do that. Maybe Nottingham Forest will also do that. They could have the advantage on the counter-attack. So, because, you know, you can be more adventurous. You can defend deep, but then be more adventurous. I think Melbourne Victory were defending deep, but they were not that adventurous. So that's something there for United. We're going to hopefully Dalot works on that. Interesting to see what he says about the game, but that might be something. Anyway, let me know in the comment section, what do you think about the game? Did you, give something that stood out to you, something that you liked, didn't like? Let us know in the comments, of course. If you did enjoy this video, smash a like for Manchester United, smash a like for the win, of course. Let's give them that. But thank you. So, but remember to subscribe to our channel on YouTube, follow us on Facebook. I don't think we'll be doing a lot of the match reactions. I think we'll mostly be United games because I'm not following a lot of preseason. But definitely subscribe. And there's a lot of other things happening. I think today will also be a big day probably for some transfers. So do subscribe because then you get notified for things that happen. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you again soon.